Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2064, fill weekend dates or every other Wednesday. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, it's spring, which means that the spring seminar season is in full bloom. I was just in Knoxville, Tennessee yesterday. A great crowd of 85 people there. If you happen to be near Columbus or Bloomington or Indianapolis or Sarasota, please come check out the seminars. There's the link right there. And during that seminar, one of the things I usually do is we control semicolon puts in the current date. We can format that as a long date, so we can see that today is Friday. How could I forget that? And then I show this cool trick where instead of just grabbing the fill handle and dragging and getting all the days like that, I right-click the fill handle, and when I let go, I choose fill weekdays, which fills just the Monday through Friday dates. All right, so that's the trick that I show all the time. And then someone came up at one of the breaks and said, "All right, well, I have the opposite problem. I want to fill weekends. They're planning a co-parenting schedule." All right, and I said, "Well, yeah, that's going to be tougher because there is no way to fill weekends, but there is this cool function in Excel that we could use to plan like sort of an employee calendar where you say equal workday from a start date, go out one day, and oh, by the way, exclude these holidays." I'm going to leave that one out right now. All right, now that's the right answer in the wrong format. You have to make sure to format that. And it will successfully give you a list of all the workdays, Monday through Friday, which is kind of like fill weekdays, but it's a formula-based way to do that. But then, you know, there's some countries where the weekend isn't Saturday and Sunday, so they created an international version of this. So equal workday.intl, here's the start date, here's the number of days, just the next day on the schedule, and then we get to specify what the weekend is, right? So if we could just specify a weekend of Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, that would be exactly what we have. But you see, there isn't a list here in the dropdown for this, all right? But here's the problem: the dropdown doesn't tell the whole story. There's a secret way to do this, where for the weekend you specify a 7-character text string. 7 characters, has to be ones or zeros. The first position is Monday, then Tuesday, then Wednesday, then Thursday, then Friday, then Saturday, then Sunday. Now this is the really weird part. This is called weekend, right? And so a 1 means don't include this day in your schedule. A 0 means include this day in your schedule. It's really kind of backwards from what you would think until you realize that it's like a double negative. All right, so here in quotes, I'm going to say, for Monday, no, Tuesday, no, Wednesday, no, Thursday, no, Friday, no, Saturday, yes, Sunday, yes. All right, I love this, the secret syntax that you will never accidentally discover through the little drop down there. You have to go into Excel help, or hey, read one of my books that documents that. Okay, so there we go with the Saturday and Sunday dates. If we needed Saturday, Sundays, and Wednesday, so we just come here, this is Monday, that's Tuesday, change that Wednesday from a 1 to a 0, and we'll get every Saturday, Sunday, and Wednesday. Yet another awesome, cool use for Excel. Well, that tip and 39 others are in the book Mr. Excel XL, the 40 Greatest Tips of All Time. All right, episode wrap-up. We can usually right-click the fill handle and drag a date to fill weekdays, but there's no similar option to fill weekends. This can be useful for planning co-parenting schedules. There's a secret form of workday.intl. 7-digit binary string specifies which day should appear on the schedule. Left to right, the digits represent Monday through Sunday. 1 means don't count this day. 0 means do include this day, which is sort of backwards. Well, there you have it. Well, I want to thank everyone who stopped into my live seminar in Knoxville yesterday. We had a great crowd, and I want to thank you for watching this video. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.